Hello and good evening. My name is John. We're here playing Avian Attorney as part of my Steam series, where I go through every game in my Steam library, eventually then arbitrarily rate and or review them after we have a playtime. Now, I don't quite know what this game is, but these games out at random, but I'm willing to bet this is a riff off of Ace Attorney, Phoenix Wright. Some would even argue that Phoenix is a bird, so we're doubly hitting it. Click to begin. New game. Options. All sorts of stuff. Oh, we can get a better resolution. That looks a little crisper. How's that look? Ooh, nice and crisp. All right, confirm. New game! Is this voice acted? January 1st, 1848. The Chateau Crenier of Baron Rourguil. Oh no! Is that Monsieur Grenouille? Oh mon dieu! Dame Kathleen, what have you done? Act 1. A cat with claws. Probable claws. It's midday already. Where on earth is that featherhead? Pharaoh. Well, well, well. Look who finally decided to get up. Haven't you heard what they say about the early bird, Falcon? Ugh, too early for worms. Pass the Cabernet Sauvignon. There'll be time for that later. We've got some business to handle first. Business? A letter arrived while you were sleeping. I should move that box over. Nope, that's not it. Not a good place for any of this. Nope. It's probably just more junk mail. Go ahead, Sparrow-son. You may have the honors. All right, ahem. Dear Monsieur Foncon, I am writing to inform you that because my daughter Dame Catalin has been arrested for a crime she did not commit, she's being held at La Conzia prison on the charge of murder, no less. Her trial is in less than 3 days' time. I'd greatly in your debt if you would offer her your legal aid. Yours sincerely, Señor Purator de Amo of the Demano Estate. Well, this is quite something. I know, your first serious client in months. Not just that, the Demano Estate is well known for its exuberant wealth. Even if we cannot do much for Dame Catherine, his lordship would still reward us handsomely for the efforts. Wow. So I suppose you're intended defending the Dame Catalina in court. Of course. Of course. It'd be foolish to let such a good opportunity slip through our feathers. Grab your coat, Sparrow-son. We're going to find our kitty client at La Concierge. Excellent. My derriere was getting all tired from the sitting around. But I better file away Sergeant Demare's letter first. One moment, Falcon. Fury's letter has been added to your evidence folder. You may access the evidence folder anytime I click on the suitcase. Ah, I never forgot my wallet. I wouldn't want to lose that. Again, I recall you losing it at New Year's party and at Christmas. Yes, all right. No need to make a list. That was a wallet. 20 francs. One note. We see how much money is carrying anytime I click on the wallet symbol. Let's make a move. The game's afoot. Or a feather. Welcome to the mat screen. From here, you can travel to any listed area by clicking on location. Name or location note. Areas marked with the clock symbol take a whole day to visit. Areas with no symbol can be visited freely. Falcon and Sparrowson step into the stone-cold foyer of the Conciergerie prison. Sullen-faced guards and visitors linger beneath the medieval archway. Ah, Conciergerie. They say this is the finest prison in the whole of France. The outer walls are impenetrable, the cells are spotless, the guards are well-mannered. Quark. What do you want? Good day, monsieur. I'm here to see Dame Catalin Demayou. I am due to represent her in court. Oh, you're a lawyer, huh? Fine, fine, follow me. Well, what are you waiting for? Keep up. Caroline is a cat. Sigh. My papa hasn't forgotten about me, has he? Dame Caroline DMO, I presume. You've arrived! The fantastic lawyer, Monsieur Falcon, and his petite assistant Sparrowson. My lady is knowledgeable. Don't talk like that, Sparrowson. Sorry. I don't get the relationship. My papa told me that he would only hire the best lawyers in town. I'm flattered. ... But they weren't available on such short notice, so he hired the first people in the address directory. Oh. You see, Falcom, I told you listening Aviary attorney would pay off. Let's get down to business. Dame Caroline, could you fill us in on some details? Your father's letter was a little brief.
I could do my best. What was it you wanted to know?
What happened the night of the murder? What exactly happened on the night of the murder?
Oh, let me think. It was Friday evening.
Me and my papa had arrived at Chateau Thinery, the home of the great Baron Rorgeru. My papa spent all evening talking to Monsieur Grenoui about the Baron, about business stuff. Business stuff?
Well, the three of them owned the railroad company together. So all through dinner they were talking about how the company shares investments, but I didn't really understand most of it.
But after dinner, the man with the camera took our photograph. That was a lot more fun. Sorry, man with the what took your what?
Camera. It's a very new gadget.
A tiny bug sits in the box with a tiny paintbrush and paints your picture very fast.
In 10 minutes, poof, you have a perfect picture.
Wow, technology, sir, is amazing. I don't think the lady explanation is right, Sparrowson.
Pshaw, let me believe.
Still, the camera sounds like a very special device. I'll make a note of it. Camera's manager evidence for. Please continue, Dame Caroline.
Well, after we had photographs, I went to the gardens to get some air, and that's when I found the body of Monsieur Grenoui. He was all ripped open. A housemaid saw me standing over the froggy monsieur and called for help. And then the police arrived. Before I could say anything, I ended up here. It was such a blur.
Must have been terrifying.
It wasn't so bad. My papa taught me how to be a brave cat. Was there something else you wanted to ask, Monsieur Falcon?
Was there that evening. Dame Caroline, who attended the banquet that evening?
Well, there was me and my papa. My dearest mama couldn't make it. And there was Baron Rogwell, and who was at dinner, and his housemaid, Caroline, I think she was called. Of course there was Monsieur Grenoui, well, until you know he died. And there was Monsieur Robito de Robino, the man with the camera, but he was only there for a little while.
Hmm.
I think that was all. Was there anything else you wanted to ask?
Did you see anything suspicious? Dame Caroline, did you see anything suspicious that evening?
Suspicious?
Like a guy lurking in the shadows or a bloody murdered weapon?
Monsieur Falcon, I do not believe you're looking for an easy answer.
You got me.
I did not see anything, I'm afraid. The evening was very normal. The food was delicious. The conversation was boring. It's all very orderly until the incident.
See.
Wait! Falcon, you missed something of huge importance.
Did?
Dame Catalan, you said the food was delicious. But you didn't say what the food it was. What food it was.
You and your darn stomach.
Let me see. We had poached red herring to start, garnished with garlic butter.
Go on.
Then marble steak, served perfectly bloody rare.
Glorious. Falcon, write this down.
What?
This can't possibly be relevant to the case.
Write it all down, please, for me.
Fine. Red herring's anti evidence folder. Bloody rare steak's anti evidence folder.
Harrison, remind me not to let you talk to clients on empty stomach. Now to think of it, I did find it a little strange that we weren't given any cutlery.
No cutlery? Even for the steak?
Nope. You would think that the great Baron of Chateau Cinerary would have gold or silverware, but there was none to be seen.
That is a little peculiar.
Is there anything else you wanted to know, Monsieur Falcon?
No, I think that'll be all.
So what's the plan now, Falcon?
The way I see it, we have two tasks. We should head to the Chateau Cinerary and try to search the scene of the murder ourselves. And we should try to track down the supposed photographer, Monsieur Robito de Robino.
2 days for two tasks seems doable.
We should head back and get some rest first. We have a lot of work ahead of us.
Wait, Monsieur Falcon. Before you go, you do believe my story, don't you?
I believe in justice. Dame Caroline, I believe in the fair trial can be drawn from the truth of any situation. I believe in justice.
That's good to hear.
You're not wrong, Falcon. But that's not what the lady needed to hear. You might want to work on being less of a... how to put it? Fils de pute. If serving justice makes me a fils de pute, then I'll wear that title proudly.
Dame Caroline, Monsieur Grenouille, Baron Rorguelli. These names are all getting a bit confusing, aren't they?
Not particularly. Not for me.
Well, it is for me. I'm going to start compiling a Facebook so that I can keep track of who everyone is.
A what?
A Facebook. It's a collection of people's names, pictures, and descriptions in one easy-to-carry catalog.
I think I understand. The name could use a little work, though.
Daryl's going to start compiling a Facebook. You can access those people you met anytime clicking on the books.
I've not met these people.
I want to know more about this gentleman here. Fioritore Domino.
Let's make a move. A new day.
Quick save any time. Right. Go to the studio.
So, this is the studio of the famous photographer. Shall we knock?
Wait, there's a note on the door. Ahem. The magnificent and marvelous artist, Monsieur Roberto de Romino, is currently out on an artistic expedition. He has to return with when his muses see fit.
When his muses see fit? What does that even mean?
I think it means he's pretending to be a bird brain, but in any case, the artist seems to be out. What should we do now?
You should knock anyway.
All right, I don't see the harm.
Da 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 da.
Nope. Looks like he's in, Falcon.
We should break in.
What? Are you serious?
Maybe?
Monsieur J.J. Falcon, I would have thought the man of justice like yourself would be against such reckless displays of unlawful barbarism.
You're right. I'm sorry. I don't know what came over.
It's a brilliant suggestion. Stand back. I'm barging the door down.
Wait, just like that? Shouldn't we discuss this first?
What in bird Jesus' name was that? Said you wanted to break in. Thought we could find an open window. I didn't think you would turn into a bird-sized cannonball. Well, now we're here. We ought to make most of it. This place is quite something. It's very... squanky?
I would say ostentatious.
That's just swanky talk for swanky.
We don't have time for this. The sound of the door being smashed could be drawing unwanted attention. We should find anything that may help our case and get out.
Investigation mode. You're free to examine the scenery of the room. Click on an item of interest. Welcome. Examine it closer in detail. All right.
I see a bourgeoisie tigress in profile.
I see paints, inks, and dyes. I'm not quite sure what the clear liquid in the bottle is. It can be taste tested.
Good, but we don't have time for a hospital visit right now.
So let's not. Finally dressed dandy fellow upon a horse. A chandelier. You should get one of those for the office.
I don't have the money for that sort of luxury.
This appears to be a photograph of a ladder, symbolic of climbing towards success, perhaps? That's more like a stepladder to me.
Oh no, we're not getting to that old argument.
A beautiful picture of Paris skyline, given the angle, this must be taken from Notre Dame Cathedral itself. A butterfly, or perhaps a moth. It's difficult to tell in black and white. This is a photographer. No, this is a tough photograph of a castle somewhere in the countryside. You know, I once had an uncle who fell off a castle rampart while on guard duty.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Did he die?
No, he got demoted.
Ugh, terrible.
A lighthouse? No, wait. It's a man in a top hat. Actually, if I squint and turn my head sideways, it's a black smudge, Malcolm.
Falcon.
This is a tiny photograph of what appears to be a jail cell. It reminds me. How illegal is this? You know, breaking, entering, rifling some person's belongings?
It's cool, we're lawyers.
It's okay. A recently passed amendment allows for proportional amounts of property damage in the pursuit of criminal evidence. I don't think that's correct, but your use of legal jargon makes me have faith in your credentials.
Sounds like you're starting to learn finer points of the French justice system, Sparrow Swan.
This is a picture of a fence. Fancy photography. Photograph.
Leaves the viewer defenseless. Out of all the pictures here, I would pick it. This is my favorite. Okay, I'm done. No more face fence puns. Maybe one more. Picture of a sailing ship on a windy day. Hey, Falcon, look! What? It's just an easel. No, look what's on the easel. Oh, wow, this was the copy of the photograph on the evening of the murder. There's no question about it. I see a housemaid, Dame Catherine. I think that's Singuer Purator, Kathleen's father. What should we do? Do we just take this? We take it. We come this far, might as well borrow it. We're the worst lawyers ever. I don't think there's anything left. Let's... I think we're done snooping. Let's get out of here before we draw any further attention to ourselves. Sounds good to me. Uh-oh. Oh, mon dieu, what happened to my door? Tell the truth. Well, Monsieur Remy, it's like this. You see, we are attorneys who have been hired for the purpose of... Raven! A raven did it! We saw the whole thing. What are you doing, Sparrowstone? I got this. I'm not going to jail because your conscience is acting up. I'm always going to jail. Just take it easy. Damn, ravens. They're always after our shiny objects. Am I right? That's incredibly raven racist. Yeah, that's right. Let's make a move. Trial's approaching fast. Right, let's go. A new day! Well, I mean, there's no point in going back. I guess we go to Chateau Crenier. Falcon and Sparrowson enter the courtyard outside Chateau Crenier. People with dirty clothes and gaunt faces linger on the building shadows. Excuse me, messieurs. I don't mean to be a pain, but my little girl and I are sick and starving, see? Cough, cough. Aww. I don't suppose you have some spare change. You have 20 francs in your wallet. What will you do? Give 1 franc. Here you go. Stay safe, madame. Many thanks to you, messieurs. That was pretty generous of you, Falcon. Times are tough. Making sure a mother and child have something to eat is the least I could do. But what am I doing here, standing here moralizing? Come on, Sparrowson. We've got a business to attend to. Boom, boom. Falco and Sparrowson step into the pristine wood panel foyer of Chateau Crenier. Wow, look at this place. Baron Roger must be loaded. More than loaded. When it comes to lucrative investment, the Baron is a legend. Factories, chocolate shop, hotels, railroads. The Baron owns a little bit of everything on the side of the sign. Sane. See you right now? Yes, he's a smug-looking chap with the impressive mane. But we must approach this man of stature with tact and finesse. Hey, Baron, we'd like a word. How was that? Sparrowson, you have the finesse of an inbred warthog. Inebriated warthog. See you later. I think I got his attention.
Did I hear my name? Great Baron Rogwell, property owner extraordinaire at your service. And who might you fellows be? More investigators?
No, we're attorneys.
Not quite. I'm the private attorney of J.J. Falcon. This is
my associate, Sparrowson.
Lawyers, eh? You know, you aren't the first to have passed through here today.
Oh?
Yes, yes, this jumpy, twitchy fellow came by this morning, asked a bunch of questions, and hopped away before he heard the answers. Most curious.
Huh.
You know who he was, Pearson?
Perhaps. I have a hunch. We've seen him at the trial.
Friend of yours?
Something like that.
What may I do for you, messieurs?
We're doing some research, Monsieur Grenouille, on Monsieur Grenouille, the frog who was killed here on Friday evening.
Of course, such a tragedy. He was a good friend and a loyal business partner. I suppose your messieurs will be wanting to see the crime scene for yourself.
Actually, yes, that'd be fantastic.
Well, be my guest. You will find the garden where the murder occurred through the back doors.
We also be interested in the lounge, the second floor, third door to the right.
That would be where we gathered for a group of photography prior to the... Unfortunate incident.
Oh, can we see the finished photograph?
I'm afraid not. It's my understanding the photograph must be developed before it can be viewed. It's a slow process. My own copy of the photograph is to be delivered in 3 days' time.
That's no good to us. The trial may be over by then.
Nevertheless, we appreciate your hospitality. Thank you, Baron. It's no trouble at all. I'll be here to see you out when you're done with your investigations.
Where do we go first?
The garden.
Dame Catelyn said she found Monsieur Grenouille on the stairs by the fountain, so it must be the very spot where the murder took place. Hey, Falcon. Do the crime scene investigation thing. The crime scene investigation thing? Yeah, you know, the thing where you get all eagle-eyed and analyze every object with excruciating detail.
You mean search for evidence?
Yeah, do that.
That's not a bad suggestion. I wouldn't be the first time Parisian police have missed something right under their noses.
A horse statue? My uncle once had a horse that refused to eat hay.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, he eventually realized it was just fulfilling on horse odors.
Oh, terrible.
Horse statue? Behooves you to stroke it? No, I would not.
Likes his horse statue. Don't mind the horse statue, but little cherub people creep me out. Baby should be waddling, not attempting to saddleless horseback riding.
Good point.
A horse statue. This one's a goofy face. That reminds me of a joke. A horse walks into the bar and the barkeeper says, "Why the long face?"
Yes, we all heard that one. What? No. The barkeeper says, "You got to stop coming here. You're drinking us under the stable."
I think it's time to rein in the horse jokes.
All right, this game's got some humor.
This fountain is finely crafted. It's solid, carved marble. That can't have been cheap.
I see nothing but water at the bottom of the lower basin. Shame we can't see inside the upper basin from here. That would be a perfect place to quickly stash a murder weapon.
That's actually not a terrible line of reasoning. We ought to wait and take a closer look, but she's sure.
Yeah, I suppose we should.
Or I apologize. I wasn't being direct enough. What I meant to say is, Sparrison, go wait in the fountain and take a closer look inside the upper basin.
Me? No way. If you want to go waddling, do it yourself.
Waiting. I'm a respectable lawyer. You can't expect me to roll up my trousers and paddle around the fountain like a duck in a lake.
Yeah, well, you don't pay me enough to just by getting my sweet threads wet.
Look, there's only one reason why to settle this.
We'll flip for it.
Flip for it?
Yeah, flip one franc coin. You call the outcome, get it wrong, and you go for a swim. But what'll it be? Heads or tails? Napoleon face or plant squiggles?
Heads. Put it all on heads. Don't let me down, old emperor.
Here we go. It's tails. Roll up your pantaloons, Falcon. You're going for a swim.
Ah, fine. Hold my shoes.
Falcon should really learn how to spot a rigged flip coin flip. He almost bad for cheating.
Almost.
Oh, you're back. Had a good swim?
No, I'm a bird, not a fish.
Did find a mystery item in the upper basin. It's no murder weapon, though. What is it? It's a brown and sticky. It's a cigar. It smells weird. Don't tell me you picked up a very wet cigar butt, possibly belonging to Baron Rogel. You're correct. But that shouldn't be too surprising. It is the house, after all. I'll stash an evidence holder, just in case.
All right.
And we got all this stuff. Wait, no.
Dried blood on the staircase.
Dried blood on the staircase. This must be where Monsieur Grenouille died. You see any bloody footprints? Ooh, or maybe a name scrawled in blood written in the frog's last breath?
Wishful thinking. All I'm seeing here is a big sticky puddle. Nothing to indicate the body was moved or the frog was a last minute clue.
All I can make out from the bloody mess is that Monsieur Grenouille was attacked and killed on the staircase. I'm not super fond of the pixel hunt requirement here. Done here. Nope. Alright, let's go to lounge. I like how she's cropped out a frame. Oh, I'm still wet too.
Second floor, third door on the right. This must be the room where the photograph was taken.
Just, hey Falcon, did you see that?
What?
That housemaid totally did something shifty.
Shifty?
I think she just pocketed something from the drawer. You totally call her out on it.
Excuse me, mademoiselle.
Ah, yes. Are you two policemen?
No, we're private attorneys. My name is J.J. Falcon.
And I'm Sparrowson. Oh, how rude of me. My name is Colleen Duhat. So, what can I help you with? What can I help you messieurs with today?
We're investigating the murder that took place last week. Do you mind if we ask a couple of questions?
That's fine. Let me just grab a chair. That's better. What was it you wanted to ask?
Is this where the photograph was taken?
I'm looking for the room where the photograph was taken prior to the incident.
Do you happen to know where this was the right room?
Oh, yes. You're in the right place. I saw the photography session for myself. Let's see. Camera was standing just about where you're standing, actually, Monsieur Falcon.
And where was the camera pointed?
Right at the clock above the mantelpiece. The Baron insisted on using that very location.
Now look at it. Something isn't right about that clock.
I know. The painting is on it totally clashes with the decor. Thinking more about obvious lines.
The clock has no hands.
That clock is never at hand in all the years I've worked here. I think Baron Roguel just keeps it around as a conversational piece. Well, we're convincing about it, so I guess it's working. Peculiar detail, though. I'll make a note of it. How do I look at it? Is there something else you wanted to ask? Something we should know. You were a little nervous when you came in. You thought we were the police officers. Something we ought to know? Anything you need to confess? No. I suppose I'm just a little nervous after all the drama last week. Pressure her. Are you sure there's anything you're hiding? Okay to tell us. We're defense attorneys. That means we help people get away with criminal acts. Right, and... Wait, what? No, that's not an accurate job description, Sparrowson. Isn't it? Oh, what do we do then? I'll tell you later. Honestly, Michaels, I have nothing to hide. Was there something else you wanted to ask? That's all. No further questions. Thank you, Mademoiselle. You've been a huge help. No problem, Michaels. Actually, there is something. I know you two saw me stealing as you came in. I appreciate that you didn't give me the third degree about it. You see, I'm trying to save up to follow my dreams, and well, never mind, I'm rambling. No problem, Mademoiselle. To be honest, we have much larger crime to worry about. Although I should probably ask, I don't suppose you've been stealing anything else. Civil War, perhaps? Ah, you know about that? Yeah, I suppose that was me. I started a couple of teaspoons. I didn't think the Baron would miss those. But, well, I suppose I got the habit a little far away from me. That's one mystery solved, at least. Civil War's bad. I'd appreciate if you didn't tell the Baron. He's really kind. I would hate to break his trust. I see. So where's the next big... Where to next, Big Bird?
Did the Mushrooms have a good look around? I trust everything was in order.
We had a good look. Thank you, Baron. But we actually have some questions for you.
Please ask away. I have nothing to hide. Baron Rogreel, I'd like to ask you about your activities on the night of the murder. Oh, am I in trouble?
Not at all.
No, nothing like that. We're just gathering full picture. See, well, let me think. Guests arrived at 5 o'clock. We all sat down for dinner in this very hall at 6. That part went magnificently. Photographer arrived at 7 o'clock, but it wasn't until 7:30 we had a picture taken. My housemaid discovered the crime soon after that. See, is there something else I can help you with, messieurs?
But your housemaid, Colleen de Haut.
She's a courteous young lady, isn't she?
Yes, she was quite helpful.
More than willing to help us with our investigation. I'm glad to hear it. Did you two want to ask something else?
They'll be leaving.
I think that'll be all, Baron. Thank you very much for your time. It was a pleasure. Have a delightful day, Munchos.
All right, is it court case time? Did we get all the information you needed, Falcon?
I hope so.
Don't worry. If everything goes wrong in the trial, we can always just... wing it!
Terrible, just terrible. Let's head back to the office and get some rest. A new day!
Falcon and Sparrowson stand inside a marble... portico of the Palace de Justice, waiting the opening of the Tribunal de Grand Instance. Are you nervous, Falcon?
Of course I'm nervous. We're woefully unprepared for this case. 2 days. We only had 2 days prepared. How are you expecting to get done anything done in that time frame?
Calm your feathers, Falcon. We can do this.
Monsieur Falcon. Petit Sparrowson, is there anything you need me to do?
No, we've got a handle on things.
Falcon was just telling me how confident he was feeling about the case.
That's wonderful. I just know you two will pull through.
Let's move along, fellas.
I'll be watching from inside. Do your best for me, Monsieur Falcon.
We will. Are we ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
All right, settle down, everyone. Settle down. Is everyone here? Judge Maxmean.
J.J. Falcon present. The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Rupert Rabington present. The ready is prosecution, Your Honor. Oh, darn, that's on it. Oh, gosh, where are my notes?
Ah, I knew it.
Knew what?
Rupert and I went to Paris Law School together. He was in all of my classes.
Oh, was he smart?
Puh, no. He always scored the second worst marks in the class. I can only assume that he bumbled through the final exam with the luck of his two rabbit's feet. Unless he's improved considerably, you might already have the trial in the bag.
That's good to know. But say, Sparrowson, if Rupert scored the second lowest of marks in class, who scored the lowest?
I choose to exercise my right to not self-incriminate.
Ah, here it is. Ahem. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
Ah, are the jury all present? All present and accounted for, Your Honor.
I like this fancy ostrich.
Hey, Falcom, I thought there were only 6 members of the jury for case studies. Why do I count 8?
Oh, those 2 birds with the funny hats are assessors, the associate judges. Everything seems in order. So let's begin. The court is now in session for the trial of Dame Caroline D'Amo. Prosecution, please call your first witness to stand.
Oh gosh, are we there already? Okay. I choose to call the officer in charge of murder investigation, Inspector Voltaire. This is the witness stand. Inspector Voltaire, please approach the stand and recite the oath.
As you will, Your Honor, I swear to speak without hatred or without fear, to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
Monsieur, Inspector, please state your name and occupation for the record.
My name is Inspector Justine Voltaire. I'm a servant of the law, a scourge of the gutter rats that plague the city. I've enforced the law for over 20 years and I'll get it until it be an infamous Veridian killer to justice. My path begins 18 years ago. Let's stick to the questions, Inspector.
Of course, Your Honor.
Oh, great. I was hoping to get one of those bumbling, cuddly officers who said we're stuck with the lawful goody two-shoes. But this guy would turn his own mother in if he saw her littering.
So, Inspector, is it true that you are the lead investigator on this case?
That is correct. I was one of the first to arrive at the scene of the crime.
And perhaps you can walk us through what you witnessed upon your arrival.
Absolutely. Just after 7:30, we were alerted and brought to the scene by a housemaid of Baron Rogrel. At the scene of the crime, we found Dame Catelyn D'Amina. She was standing on the corpse of Monsieur Grenouille with his blood on her paws.
Well, that sounds like an open-shut case, in my humble opinion. No more questions, Your Honor.
Bloodied paws? No one told me that detail.
Keep it together, Falcon. You're about to be given the opportunity to cross-examine the witness. That's your opportunity to find flaws in the inspector's testimony.
Of course. I know this. Begin your cross-examination, Monsieur Falcon.
All right. Okay. Okay. They were alerted and brought to the scene by the housemaid. At the scene of the crime, we found Dame Catelyn. She was standing over the slice of her corpse.
Light as about the corpse of Monsieur Grenouille. Go on. Tell me of the slash.
Inspector, could you describe the cut of Monsieur Grenouille's corpse?
Certainly. It was a single vertical slash. It was fine and deep cut, the sort you expect to see from a sharpened saber or a surgeon's knife.
Or a cat's claw?
Certainly. Wait. You said a saber or knife could have inflicted the wound? Isn't this a line of investigation worth pursuing?
Don't be daft, Falcon. Do you see anything about a knife or sword at the crime scene?
Did I?
How do I look at it?
This is a red herring. I did. There was a sword in the main hall. Wasn't there? I think the police would have noticed something like that. No, Monsieur Falcon, there was no sword at the crime scene. Judge. I concur. Defense perfectly aligned. Oh no. Was the cause of death? Immediately, I was on the scene. Monsieur Grenouille's gaping slash from shoulder to thigh. Blood was everywhere. I spoke with the coroner. It was in agreeance. Frog died from blood loss directly causing an open wound. D. No chance of arguing this was an unrelated injury, huh? You have another question about the corpse?
But you say you learned about seeing a Baron Rodil's housemaid.
That is correct. What was her name? The housemaid's name was Colleen de Haunt. We found her running from the Chateau Canier with tears in her eyes.
Colleen. That was the thieving giraffe lady, wasn't it? We questioned her extensively, but didn't find anything implicate.
As far as we are connected, Colleen de Haunt is not a suspect.
Right.
That one. You say you found Dame Catelyn at the scene of the crime.
Correct.
The suspect was standing right beside the victim's body. Find anything out of the ordinary. Out of the ordinary? Missing garden tools, broken fences, that sort of thing. Definitely not. We went in the garden and came up empty. Nothing but marble horse statues and properly trimmed grass. That seems pretty definitive. Yes? You say standing right beside. Would you say that two or less than the meter away? I would say around 3 feet. Feet? I'm not familiar with the British measurements. How many feet are in a meter? Well, there are 12 inches in a foot and 2.5 centimeters in an inch, so we need a pen and paper. 12 inches in a foot, that's just plain silly. Monsieur Falcon, is this going anywhere? Yes. Yes, Your Honor. Metric system is going towards a unified system of measurements for the entire world. Assuming those stubborn-ass Americans don't drop the ball, that is. Remember for the trial. Does this line of questioning have any purpose in contact with the trial? Not in any form whatsoever, Your Honor. And stop wasting our time. Alright. But do you say Dame Carlyon had blood on her paws? Correct. Blood clung to her fur like guilt to a convict. How much blood was there? How much blood was there on Lady's paws, Inspector? Enough for it to be clear she had dirtier hands than the victim's body. We noticed blood under the suspect's nails, around her fingertips, and even around her mouth. Her mouth? How vile. Inspector Anstey is pretty definitive. Yes. Whose blood was it? Whose blood was it? Ah, what a question. It was Monsieur Grenouille's, of course. How can you be so sure? I object. This is a line of questioning absurd. There was only one murder victim tonight, Falcon. Blood and Dame Clarion paws could have belonged to one person, Monsieur Grenouille. Judge, Falcon's trying to lay the trial by asking pointless questions. Afraid the prosecution may have a point, Monsieur Falcon. Do you have any reason to believe the blood belonged to someone other than Monsieur Grenouille? I do, Your Honor. Actually, I have more suspicion. I have evidence the blood on Dame Clarion paws has nothing to do with the murder. This is foolish time wasting, Falcon. Blood on Dame Clarion didn't come from the victim. Where did the blood come from? On the evening of the murder, Dame Catalina. A bloody rare steak. Is that true, Monsieur Remington? In a matter of speaking, I suppose the steak may have been on the, you. Then, Inspector, would you acknowledge the possibility that the blood on the lady's paw did not belong to the victim, but to the steak? Well. Wait, don't answer that, Inspector. It's a possibility. No! Intriguing. Pretty convincing. Gained little favor with the jury. Inspector Voltaire, is it possible that you arrested an innocent bystander for simply being a messy eater? Now hold on just 1 minute, Falcon. You're overlooking something quite crucial. Dame Catalina's excellent Bourgogne kitten. You would no doubt have brought up with flawless etiquette and on perfect table manners. Banquet, she would have eaten a steak with a fork in her left hand and a knife in her right, like any properly civilized animal. How could she probably have blood on her paws, such good manners? Oh, that's a good question. Or at least it would be in any ordinary dinner banquet. As it happened, something was in the particular banquet. Something that forced Dame Catalina to eat with her paws. Dame Catalina was forced to eat steak with her paws because the silverware of the household had been previously stolen. Stolen? I don't recall I mentioned that in a police report. We weren't aware of anything missing from Rodrigo's residence when we performed the initial investigation. But as it happens, Baron Rodriguez approached us about this very subject last night. Ah! Innocence, perhaps? What a twist! Gain favor of the jury. What is the meaning of all this? Bloody steak, misplaced silverware? Inspector, your investigation was so lax you overlooked these basic facts in your initial report? Lax? My investigation, Judge, I assure you, I'm the most thorough investigator office on the force. That is amazing, the Parisian police managed to solve any crimes at all. Eh. Oh dear. Be on your way, Inspector. Perhaps do a little inspecting for your next case. Fine, so be it, Monsieur. Until next time. Prosecutor, I trust your next witness is ready. Yes, of course, Your Honor. I call upon, Monsieur Roberto Rabino, the photographer who attended the banquet of the last night's murder. Monsieur Roberto Rabino, please approach the stand and recite the oath. How does it go? I swear to speak without hatred and without fear, to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth. A little cliche, to be perfectly honest. Could the witness please introduce himself for the court record? Huh. Does anyone in this courtroom does not immediately recognize me? I'm the great Monsieur Roberto Rabino, a cutting-edge photographer and visionary. Don't just take people's pictures, I capture the very essence. Je suis l'artiste to a Ellen Pipe. You may have seen my works in the magazine Le Branche or C'est Surlette. I'll send you tweets if you like. What on earth is a tweet? Bird-to-bird communication. Come on, Falcon, it's the 19th century. Get with the times already. Yes, your works are very impressive, Monsieur Roberto. Well, let's get down to business. Could you tell us the activities of the night of the murder? Very well. I was hired by Baron Rangel to capture an evening's events. Arrived at 7 in the evening, pointed my camera, captured a beauty banquet for one fantastic photograph. Then I billed the Baron Raguil and left, like a true artist. And with regards to the photograph itself, what did you photograph? I thought you might ask. I bought a copy so you all can see for yourself. Oh, very good. Let's take a close look. My word, there's a description pigeon. Let's see who we have here. Then we see a Baron Raguil, the lion host of the event. Left we see a Senor Pereira de Mina, the father of the defendant, Dame Cataline. And finally we see the housemaid, Caloon de Haunt, who I expected may have stuck into the picture uninvited. As you can see, two people are clearly absent from the photograph. The first is victim, Monsieur Grenouille. The second is defendant, Dame Cataline de... quite suspicious, won't you agree? Just a moment, Monsieur Robinson. This proves nothing. So the defendant and the victim were not photographed the others. That doesn't mean they were in the garden together at that point. Hold your horses, Falcon. I'm not done yet. The prosecution may continue. Behind the photography subjects, we see the wall clock with the time set at 7:30. Now, why is that time significant? Well, as Inspector Botona told us earlier, that was the exact time the murder took place. You see, Falcon? Every suspect is at the time of the murder, save for Dame Cataline herself. Hey, Falcon, that photograph doesn't seem right. It looks different than the one we borrowed from Rubido's studio. I see it too. Our photograph shows Caroline de Hunt, Dame Cataline, and Senor Porritor. But Monsieur Robinson's photo shows Baron Rangin where Dame Cataline should be standing. If we assume that only one photograph was taken, this demonstrates one photograph must have been edited in some way. You should have slammed the evidence down. Be like, bam, inconsistency. The whole courtroom is out of order. Case closed. I can't do that. Well, I suppose you can be a little more delicate with your work. No, I mean, I can't do that because our evidence is legally obtained. If I were to present it, Monsieur Robinson would ask how we acquired it, and the whole trial would be derailed. In worst case scenario, I could lose my legal license, and we'd be arrested for theft. Oh, well, we don't want that. No, we don't. I should tread lightly. Your Honor, I'd like to cross-examine the witness. Very well. Defendant may proceed. Waste of time, if you ask me. Photographs are rock-solid evidence. Monsieur Rubido, you said you arrived at 7 o'clock. Here, take a couple minutes, yes. How long did it take to set up? 25 minutes to find the shooting location, put the camera together, and ready the film. So you arrived at 7... Okay, just typically 7:30. You spent 25 minutes setting up. At least 5 minutes unaccounted for. Okay, surely the answer is that Monsieur Ramino did something nefarious in a small window of time. No, I am not. Not at all. I'm just trying to piece together the evening's events. Spent a little time talking with Baron Wheel when I arrived. That's probably where the rest of the time went. Do you have any other question? How did you know what time arrived at? How do you know that you arrived at 7? Well, the clock at my house was 6:45 and left, and I walked to the Chateau Chimay around 15 minutes. I don't claim to be flawless time here, but I'm professional. I always stick to my appointment. Okay. Take a look at the photograph. I see a mistake in the photograph. Just to clarify, Monsieur Robito, the photographs are a direct reflection of reality, are they not? That is correct. The photographic process leaves no room for bias or inaccuracy. That is most curious, because I see a mistake. A mistake? Impossible. I just told you, Monsieur, the camera is perfect, unbiased device. The photographs it produces are flawless. Fuck, I'm not seeing any mistakes. Can I be more specific? Certainly. Clock in the photograph. There's something not right about it. Well, isn't that convenient? The defense sees something wrong with the key piece of evidence that implicates his client. Don't give me that cocky tone, Monsieur Ravington. I have evidence that there's something wrong with the clock in the picture. The photograph clearly shows the clock hands pointed at 7 and 6. Much self-evidence. Which is most curious, because the clock in the lounge of Chateau Crenere has no hands. It has no hands! The clock is merely a decorative piece, a talking item. Feel free to ask Baron Renta or his housemate if you have any doubts. Monsieur Ramino, how do you explain this discrepancy? I don't know. There must be some sort of mistake. My camera is flawless. There's no mistake, Monsieur. Your photograph depicts something that does not exist in the real world. Maybe there was an error in the printing process. An error precisely where the clock hand should be? Please, Monsieur, don't patronize it. Allow me to offer a more plausible explanation. You, Monsieur Ramino, edited this photograph. Edited? I'm no expert, but I suspect that you used paint or ink to carefully put hands on it. Would have been a simple task considering the face, clock face was bare. One could even speculate that you specifically chose to include handless clocks in the photograph just to simplify the editing process. Falcon, your reasoning is absurd. Why would the witness do such a thing? Is it not obvious? By showing the photograph to taking place precisely at 7:30, it clears all the photograph's suspects of suspicion. In other words, Monsieur Romino created the perfect alibi. Of course, that raises further questions. Who is the witness protecting? And why? Why was Monsieur Romino corrected? And coerced, I should say, bribed, threatened? Enough silence. Let's hear some answers, Monsieur Romino. Fine, you got me. I'm guilty. I did it all. You did it? You're confessing the murder of Monsieur Grenouille? What? No. I have no idea who killed the frog. I'm just admitting that guilty of producing fraudulent photographs. I was ordered to make changes to the printed photographs. And yes, that included adding hands to the clock. You were ordered? By whom? I dare not say. Monsieur Romino, I strongly advise you to answer the defense's question. You have pledged to speak without fear, after all. With respect, Judge, I fear his claws more than I feel the punishment of the justice system. I shall name no names. His claws. You hear that, Falcon? That is most unfortunate. Monsieur Romino, we cannot and shall not torture names out of you. We don't live in our ancient regime, after all. But since you have admitted to falsifying evidence, then we cannot keep you on the stand as a witness. Take your leave. You shall be charged with perjury in due course. I can't protest. That is the least I deserve for my failure as an artist. Good day, monsieurs. Intriguing. Pretty convincing. So the clock hands are painted on. So what? It doesn't matter. Photograph still depicts Dame Catalina as absent close to the time of the murder. That's significant. Don't be dense, Monsieur Remington. The photograph is not completely genuine, then it cannot be considered reliable evidence. Why not? It's still a portrait of the night's events. Because if we accept one part of the picture is edited, then we must accept the possibility that other parts were too. It's possible that Dame Catalina was painted out, or even worse, it's possible another person was painted in. We know the witness was trying to cover someone, so all possibilities must be accounted for. What do you say, Falcon? That the household maid paid off the photographer, or was Signor Pindia de Min, perhaps? I don't think so. The housemaid lacks the mean or motive. That would make sense for Signor Purrington to implant his own daughter. While surely not suggesting the hottest beloved Baron Rodrigo deliberately tried to frame Dame Catalina, because that would be most outlandish theory yet. The Baron is a pillar of our community. We'd never do such a thing. Monsieur Remington, I'm not here with the accusation. That's the job of you, the prosecutor, however. May I perhaps offer an opinion? Baron, it's not out of time for witness testimony yet. So you would think, prosecutor, and yet I see good reputation getting tarnished by your incompetence.
Incompetence?
Indeed. Let us proceed the witness questioning. Is this fine with you, Judge? Yeah, I suppose that's fine. Very good. And I trust the defense has no objections? No objections here. Fantastic. Oh, but before I forget, I pledge to speak without fear, prejudice, etc., etc. Now, prosecutor, ask me what witness over the course of the evening.
Oh, okay. Baron Roguel, on the night of the
initial dinner was magnificent. When the photographer arrived, Monsieur Grenouille left to visit the garden. Dame Catalina followed behind him moments later. Signor Purrington, Monsieur Rubino, and myself were engaged in conversation, so we paid her no mind. After the photographer left, my housemaid left to follow by Monsieur Grenouille and Dame Catalina. That would be when I heard a cry for help. Thank you, Baron. I think we all know the story from here. I had to cross the hands of the witness. You doubt my integrity, Garcon? I'm just here to uncover the truth, Baron. Very well, then. Hit me with your best shot. Let us establish absolutely certainly I, Baron Rodrigo, is an honest man. Defense may proceed with the cross-examination. Okay. Garden. Baron, we saw the murder scene for your garden ourselves. When was the last time you visited it? Baron Rodwell, when was the last time you ventured in your own garden? As it happens, I have quite serious allergies. I haven't been to my garden for over years. Years, you say? Indeed. That's not right. Baron, I know we should call you a liar, but that claim does not hold up to scrutiny. Oh, and why is that? Because we have hard evidence that you visited the garden recently. Balderdash, my word is gold. Show the court the so-called hall evidence that I've been in my garden. This was found in your garden. To be specific, it was found inside the fountain basin. Right beside where the murder occurred. A cigar butt. That could belong to anybody, and... Prosecutor, please shut your mouth. I can speak for myself.
Okay, sorry, Baron.
That is indeed a reference of my cigars, but I must apologize, Monsieur Falcon. I misunderstand your initial question. You see, prior to the banquet, I hadn't visited my old garden in years. But naturally, after hearing the housemaid's cry for help on that evening of the murder, I rushed outside. I was shocked to discuss what I saw. That must have been when I dropped my half-smoked cigar in the fountain basin. You see, Falcon, there's a perfectly reasonable explanation. I would find that believable the cigar was casually discarded, but as it happened, the cigar was found in the fountain's upper basin, a location that could only be accessed with great inconvenience. A little paddling. The cigar butt was not dropped, it was deliberately hidden. There are a number of possibilities. Are there? Because I only think of one. That is you, Baron Rogel, deliberately hid your own cigar butt to disguise your own illicit activities. Did I know? And what else activities would those be? You want me to spell it out? Fine. Put everything on the table. You, Baron Ragil, murdered Monsieur Gwenwee. This is what you were trying to keep hidden. Directly accusing me of murder. How shamelessly brazen. That is ludicrous accusation, Falcon. The Baron is an upstanding citizen of the highest order. Your allegation is baseless. You have no evidence. No means, motives, opportunities. No evidence? Think harder, Monsieur Robinson. Every piece of evidence points to Baron Raguel as the prime suspect. You want the means? The Baron certainly had means. His lion claws are as sharp as a surgeon's blade. Getting a frog belly would be trivial to him. Even Monsieur Robinson confessed just a moment ago that he feared his claws. Ridiculous. I would never threaten a man with violence. You want a motive? The Baron has at least 10,000 francs worth of motive. By removing business partner, the Baron's share of the royal company increased from 1/3 to 1/2. This is preposterous. Finally, Baron opportunity. No, he crafted the perfect opportunity. He arranged a small banquet with a very select number of guests. He was aware of the missing silverware, and yet he served a steak, a food item that was necessity good cutlery. Why? To bloody the hands of his guests, of course. And then he hired an easily influenced photographer and staged a very specific picture in order to build the perfect alibi for himself. Photographing the guests in front of a handless clock to make it easy editing is quite an ingenious plan, must be said. Prosecutor, are you just going to let this slanderous yarn go uncontested? Say something. Object. Oh, you're pitifully useless. After executing the murder, the Baron found himself still holding a single piece of incriminating evidence, his finished cigar. He knew that leaving out the crime scene would raise suspicion, but he didn't have the time to properly dispose of it. But out of desperation, he threw it in his fountain, out of sight of his guests and any assuming police. I imagine the Baron was hoping to implicate Signor Perrington de Mia, since that would have ensured total control over his railroad company. The last Dame Cataline was the first person to happen upon the crime scene, so the Baron improvised. This is outrageous. Judge, I demand you to bar this ranting lunatic. No, there is only one outrage here. That is, a man like yourself be able to abuse his wealth and status to frame an innocent girl for murder. You're a bourgeoisie of the worst kind. How dare you, garçon? The utter nerve-relying scumbag of a lawyer to accuse a philanthropist of myself is something of so hideous. I'm not like the fat-clad bourgeoisie. I'm a respectable, hard-working capitalist. No, you're a ruthless man who slaughtered a dear friend just to reap a few francs. Your incredulous wealth, while I got you right here like now, like that, like a damn frog. Someone please restrain the Baron? I'm on it, Your Honor. Let's go, old man. To the congrery with you. Don't touch me, you filthy jackdaw. I can walk for myself. Quite a turn of events. Does the prosecution have anything else to add?
No.
I shall now confer with the members of the jury to come to a decision. I ask the animals of the court to please be patient in this time.
Falcon, that was pretty incredible.
Thank you. I just hope it was enough.
What do you mean? You just proved Cataline's innocent. We'll get not guilty for sure.
Barrison, I think you're misunderstanding something important about the justice system.
What's that?
I haven't proved anything. As lawyers, we cannot deal in proofs. It's just not possible. All we can do is organize the evidence and convincingly explain what it suggests. I haven't proven Dame Cataline's innocent. All I've done is demonstrate that there's significant possibility that she is not guilty.
I'm not sure that I understand the difference.
We have Regia's decision. The light of the recent evolution is clear and the error of judgment was made in the initial arrest. On that note, we unanimously find the defendant, Dame Cataline de Meu, to be not guilty.
Monsieur Falcon, petite Sarson, you did it.
Yeah, I suppose we did, didn't we? We shall head back to the office so we can celebrate properly. You did it, Falcon. I take all the credit. The group achievement. Okay, we did it. We got the first case done. This has been Avian Aturi. It's a bit of a visual novel, bit of a hidden object, bit of a adventure game. Very close to the Phoenix Wright series. I like it. I think it's cute. A lot of good puns. Not sure I'm 100% sold on the black and white imagery, but it does fit the era of the time. Yeah, overall, pretty cool. Cheers.